Hello students, let me start the audio presentation, and it is related with the Lebanon talk. I hope you are all fine. So actually in this particular audio discussion, I will discuss the introduction related with this poem, and also side by side I will discuss the complete summary of this poem also. So let's get started. The Lebanon talk, introduction of the lesson and complete summary. This short poem just depicts a scene in the wilderness. Lebanon tree stands there silent and still. It has a nest built on it, and this nest was built by the goldfinch bird. The little mother bird goldfinch arrives to meet and feed her young ones. Actually, young ones means the baby chicks or the baby birds. Sitting at one end of a branch, it gives a signal sound. The young ones recognize their mother's voice and start chirping. Chirping, you can say it is like twittering or chirping, making some noise like some engine. The bird, alert and swift, makes her way to the nest. When the purpose of her visit to meet and feed the little ones is accomplished, she flies away. So after feeding her young ones, again she flies away. At the very beginning, the Lebanon tree itself is still and silent, but with the arrival of the goldfinch, there is an activity can be noticed, what can be defined as a feverish activity can be noticed. But with the departure of the goldfinch, once again after feeding her baby chicks, again the Lebanon tree subsides to emptiness, or rather to say in other words, again the Lebanon tree becomes still and silent. So let me continue. When the purpose of her visit to meet and feed the little ones is accomplished, she flies away. This is how the cycle of life and multiplication goes on in nature. It is all instinctive. It is all natural. It is all instinctive. The mother bird makes a nest amongst the thick leaves of a tree. It brings up her chicks, that is her baby birds, until they are strong enough to fly and find their food on their own. Now, the mother goldfinch works very hard to provide foods for her baby birds until and unless the birds, they can start flying and become self-independent. Before that, the process of providing them nourishment and food, this particular work was being done by the mother goldfinch. She actually acts as the engine of her family, and the machine is actually the baby birds. So she provides the food, just like to start off a machine, lubricator is provided that actually energizes the machine. So actually she means the mother goldfinch, she acts as the engine of her family, and the baby birds, they are the machine. So let me continue. The mother bird makes a nest amongst the thick leaves of a tree. It brings up her chicks until they are strong enough to fly and find their food on their own. The Lebanon top is silent and motionless. I already told you all regarding this. On a September afternoon, even it is mentioned in your poem also, September, then autumn season, all these things are mentioned. The golden sunlight is spread on it. The few leaves left on the tree are turning yellow in autumn. I already told you it is autumn season, as been mentioned in the poem. And the month is September, that is also mentioned in the poem. All the seeds have already fallen to the ground. But the silence is broken with the arrival of a small singing mother bird, goldfinch. She has returned to meet, not only to meet, but also to feed her baby birds. It makes a jerky chirping sound from the branch end. That was the signal sound that she gives on her arrival. She makes a sort of a sound from the other end of the branch of the tree. The mother's arrival creates a sudden stir and noise. It creates a sort of a feverish activity, dear students. It creates a lot of stir and noise because all of a sudden the Lebanon tree is full of activity with the arrival of the goldfinch. So I repeat this line. द मदर्स अराइवल क्रिएट्स अ सडन स्टायर एंड नॉइज दैट स्टार्टल्स द साइलेंस स्प्रेड ऑल अराउंड द लिटिल यंग वंस आर देयर इन अ नेस्ट एंड देयर मदर केम टू प्रोवाइड देम फूड द लिटिल बर्ड हैज अ स्मूथ एंड शाइनी बॉडी as that of a lizard and that is the reason in your text it is mentioned the bird is alert and abrupt as a lizard even its movement is also very sleek as that of a lizard so let me continue she is extremely watchful and swift the nest is built securely the bird enters the thick bunch of leaves and twigs actually twigs means small branches of a tree And at once the tree comes alive like a noisy machine or engine. It is the engine of her little ones. I already told you all regarding this. The goldfinch, the mother goldfinch acts as the engine for her baby birds or for her baby chicks. They too start chirping in excitement. They flap their little wings and put up a confusing noise. As soon as they see their mother, they went on flapping their wings, they went on making a lot of chirpings and twitterings side by side. And all of a sudden, the laburnum tree that was still and silent, all of a sudden, there is a feverish activity goes on in the tree. All of a sudden, the entire tree becomes noisy with the arrival of the goldfinch. But remember, dear students, again with the departure of the goldfinch bird, again the laburnum tree subsides to silence or emptiness. Again it becomes quiet. So, I am moving on to the last paragraph now in this discussion part. It is the mother bird who creates all such noise to a high pitch. Then having fed her chicks, that is her baby birds, she flies out of the nest to a branch. Her face bears stripes which are its identity marks, a sort of marks on her face. The purpose of her visit is fulfilled. As if it can be seen, there are stripes on her face. It seems that she is wearing a mask and her purpose has been fulfilled because her main purpose was to provide nourishment and food to her baby chicks. Or rather to say, to her baby birds. So let me continue. A shot of marks on her face, the purpose of her visit is fulfilled. The bird once again flies away towards some unknown place, far away. Silence as usual returns to the little tree again. And after the goldfinch bird flies out once again, the laburnum tree again becomes still and silent just it was before the arrival of the goldfinch. So dear students, that was the intro part as well as the overview of the summary or concept related to this poem. I hope that you have understood it. Because this was been done previously also, just a revision way, in a revisional way I have conducted this audio presentation. Please listen to it and if there is any doubt, kindly let me know. Thank you students. Thank you all.